A very good morning. Today we are going to discuss the introductory part of Civil Procedure Code 1908. When we discuss about the Civil Procedure Code, there is one most important part which is called the introductory part. Ki why the act was enacted? We can say that in India, the entire judicial system is divided into two parts. The first is the civil and the other one is the criminal. We do have laws which can be run only in civil courts. So this act is basically talking about the procedural part of the code. The entire scheme of CPC, it can be divided into two parts. There are few sections. At the same time, there are orders and rules. So when we talk about why there is such kind of partition is there in CPC, the main reason behind this, the order along with the rules specifically talking about the procedure. Okay, what should be done in a particular civil court after filing a suit. Okay, the entire detailed process is given in the order, and these sections are just talking about the principles which are applicable to the courts. Okay, in between, what is the res judicata, principle of res judicata, principle of res judice. Okay, so the meaning of certain words, introduction to certain doctrines, it is given under the sections, and on the other part, the sequencing. Okay, the order, how the process will go on in a civil court, it is given in the order. So entire CPC is divided into two parts. In the first introductory part of CPC, there is section 1. Section 1 of the act is divided into two parts, the application of the act and the name of the act. The Civil Procedure Code will be known as Civil Procedure Code 1908, date of commencement 1st January 1909. Second part, it is applicable to all over India except Jammu and Kashmir and certain areas of Nagaland and tribal areas. And in tribal areas, we are talking about the tribal areas of Assam. So there are two important things under section 1, the name of act, and second, the application. Third, we can say the date of commencement. So this section is divided into three parts: name, CPC 1908, application to all over India except Jammu and Kashmir, Nagaland and tribal areas, and third, the date of commencement is 1st January 1909. The second section, it is a definition clause. Section 2 is having the definition of the various terms, and this is the most important part of CPC. The first definition which we are going to discuss, it is under section 2.9. Okay, under section 2 clause 9. This is the definition of judgment. Okay, so when we talk about what is a judgment, judgment is the formal expression of a judge in the form of decree or order. So there are two important things. The judgment is given by a judge. It is a formal expression. There is a format which is followed by the judge to give his judgment. So this particular provision is judgment, the formal expression of a judge in the form of decree or order. Again, the definition of decree is given under section 2 clause 2, and definition of order is given under section 2 clause 14. Okay, so this particular section is talking about what is decree and what is order. So first, the definition of decree. Decree under section 2 clause 2. Okay, what is decree? Okay, why it is differentiated from the order? So remember, okay, when we are talking about what is a decree is a formal adjudication of a judge. Second thing, it talks about the matter in dispute. It talks about the rights of a party in a particular matter. So when there is a decree passed by a judge, it is a formal adjudication of a court and which determines the rights of the parties, who are the parties in a particular matter of dispute. So decree always decides the rights of a duty. When we are talking about the rights, it means it is imposing certain kind of liability to the other party. So formal expression of adjudication decides the matter in dispute. It talks about the rights of the parties. And rejection of a plaint. If a plaint is rejected under Order 7, Rule 11, there are certain grounds are given. If on these grounds, if a decree will be considered as a decree. Okay, so rejection of a plaint is a decree. And second, under Section 144, if there is a decision of restitution under Section 144, it is also a decree. Okay, so there are two things we have to remember. Ki what is a decree? Decree is a formal adjudication of a court given by the judge in a matter of dispute between the parties, and it talks about the rights of the parties. Okay, and rejection of a plaint is a decree. Decision under Section 144 for the restitution, it is a decree. So remember, it always talks about the parties in disputes and their rights. Second thing, if there is any matter, ki appeal lies as an appeal of an order, it never be a decree. Okay, jahan appeal order ki appeal ki tarah hoti hai, wo decree mein shamil nahi hoga. And remember, this is the most important part of CPC. Because, for example, when we are talking about the decree, ki for example, in a matter, the matter is relating to the maintenance. X is entitled to get maintenance because she is a legally wedded wife of the husband and she is having a reasonable ground to get maintenance from her husband. So this particular thing, X is the legally wedded wife of Y, and that's why she is entitled to get maintenance from her husband. If such kind of decision is given by the court, it is a decree, because it talks about it is a right of X. She can get maintenance from the husband. So it is a decree. But suppose the order is passed by the court ki X can recover 5 lakh rupees from Y. It is an order. It is not talking about the statement given by the judge is not talking about any kind of rights of the parties, ki why he is entitled, why she is entitled to get this particular thing, particular amount, particular recovery money. So this is just an order. So it means any adjudication which is given by a judge and which is not a decree, it is an order. So decree always talks about the rights of the parties. Parties are having certain dispute in a particular matter regarding their rights, and court gives a formal expression in the form of adjudication. This is decree. So this is Section 2-3 decree, 2-2 decree, and 2-3 remember decree holder. Decree holder means a person who, in whose favor a decision is given by the court on the another matter. 2-2-2-9 is judgment, and 2-10 is the judgment debtor. It means against whom a decree is passed. So these are the important terms under Section 2 of CPC. The first thing, what is decree? Under Section 2-2, what is order, which is not a decree, it is an order, 2-14. Third, what is judgment under Section 2-9? Who is judgment debtor against whom a decree is passed? And who is decree holder, in whose favor is a decree is passed by the court? These are the important definition. It is the first introductory part of CPC. In next class, we will discuss the other definition given under Section 2. Thank you.